say who you are, just introduce yourself. Who are you and where do you come from?
Beryl Morris. St. Mark's is my church. I come from Wythenshawe.
Right.
I've been here 44 years in Wythenshawe.
Wow.
Before that, I lived in, well, near Old Trafford.
Oh, yeah.
So, and then the houses came down where we live, and we was rerouted to Wythenshawe.
Okay.
I felt quite lonely at first. Didn't know anybody till a friend knocked at the door and said hello, and that was it. I started making friends.
Right. And when did you start being part of the church in Woodhouse Park in Wythenshawe? When was that?
When the children were small. Peter's 50 now, and I think he was about 9 years old, and I went to William Temple with a friend.
Right.
I didn't know any of the churches round, and I asked her, because she was a church going lady, and I asked her could I go to church with her, and she said yes, of course.
Right.
And they made me very welcome.
Lovely.
And Tracy was christened there.
Yeah.
Peter was confirmed. He was in the scouts there.
Yeah. Right.
And then, of course, he grew up, and eventually, I came to this church.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
And on and off, I've been ever since.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And Beryl, what does following Jesus mean to you?
Everything. Everything. I just wouldn't feel I'd got a complete life if I didn't have my faith.
Right.
I mean, my people who say they've no faith and they can go on. I couldn't, but that's me.
Right.
The distress and the wonderful things that happened in my life, it's always been there for me.
Right.
Without being dramatic, there's times I really needed him. He's always been there, especially when my husband was dying of cancer. He, I just feel he was in the background. You know, I'm here for you, Beryl.
Right.
And he was.
Yeah.
And he was there for Stan, which was more important.
Right.
And especially the girls, it was traumatic losing the father. But they, even now, they'll say, we know he's being looked after.
Right.
You know, like some people say they don't believe in an afterlife. I don't know what an afterlife is. I just trust God. And if things go wrong, I do get angry with him.
Yeah.
Yeah. But you would with a friend, wouldn't you?
Yeah,
and that's what I think of him.
Yeah.
It, to me, it's like the head of, not my family, everybody's family. And you quarrel with them, don't you?
Yeah.
And sometimes I say to him, this isn't fair. But I know he's smiling and saying, no, this isn't fair, Beryl. And if I could have prevented it, I would. And that's a lot of my faith. I came to that many years ago when I thought, stop blaming him. He can't help you, but it can help you afterwards to cope. So, yes, but that's a personal thing. Probably ministers don't believe that. I do. I know he's God Almighty, but like a lot of parents, I think they sometimes things happen and it's going to happen, but they'll be there to support you. And I think with God, that is it for me.
Right.
You know, I'm distressed, and I think you're powerful enough. Could you stop it? And then I think, oh no, perhaps you couldn't. That's just too much going on, and far more important things. But that's just me, Kate. You know, I might be very wrong, but that's. I feel comfortable.
That's your understanding, yeah.
I feel comfortable saying, I know you doubt if you could, You can't. But at least you're giving me support.
Yeah.
But my son was a good man.
Yeah.
And when he died, it was, his children was, oh, they didn't know what to do.
No.
But the support I got from my faith. And then my ministers, but mostly my faith.
Yeah.
I thought, yeah, he's gone, and he's, we can't help them. No. Yeah, and when we lost our baby, the same, she would come back, and then no, she's never the judge, that little tiny soul, and one day I'll tell him to be loads of balls, I think he'll smile and say, well, never mind, come in the back door.
Yeah, thank you, Beryl.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Okay.